Welcome to our church, to what we want to be, a family of love. Welcome to familiar faces. Welcome to first-timers. Welcome to the old and the young and the somewhat in-betweens. Welcome to a place of warm friendship, acceptance and fun. Welcome to a space of silence and solitude. Welcome to a place of joy and laughter. Welcome to an encounter with the unchanging, abundant, steadfast love of God. His generous banquet is lovingly prepared with you in mind. Welcome to the silly and the serious, the honest and the pretending, the lonely and the crowded. Welcome to those who need to be held and those who need to be released. Welcome as you are, a precious part of God's family. Welcome to our church. Let's pray. Father, we approach you, finding a place to be with you, seeking to meet you in a special way, to hear your voice, to know your power, to be strengthened to live. Meet us in the way you would touch us, where we need, guide us how to go. We ask, Amen. Our first song is Before the Throne of God Above. You do join in if you know it, otherwise just listen to it and get to know it.
Because the sinless Savior died, My sinful soul is counted free, for God the just is satisfied to look on Him and pardon me, to look on Him and pardon me, because a sinless Savior died. My sinful soul is counted free, for God the just is satisfied to look on Him and pardon me, to look on Him and pardon me.
Today's reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke. About 8 days later, Jesus took Peter, John, and James up on a mountain to pray. And as he was praying, the appearance of his face was transformed, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly, two men, Moses and Elijah, appeared and began talking with Jesus. They were glorious to see, and they were speaking about his exodus from this world, which was about to be fulfilled in Jerusalem. Peter and the others had fallen asleep. When they woke up, they saw Jesus' glory and the two men standing with him. As Moses and Elijah were starting to leave, Peter, not even knowing what he was saying, blurted out, "Master, it's wonderful for us to be here. Let's make three shelters as memorials, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." But even as he was saying this, a cloud overshadowed them, and terror gripped them as the cloud covered them. Then a voice from the cloud said, "This is my son, my chosen one. Listen to him." When the voice finished, Jesus was there alone. They didn't tell anyone at that time what they had seen.
So mountains are one of those things that were significant to the spirituality of the Israelites and often significant to spiritual experiences. Many people talk about meeting with God when they're out in the countryside, when they go to beautiful places. Somehow they get a sense of awe and inspiration. Mountains are also difficult and dangerous places, and those who go up them know that they have to be careful. Jesus chose to go with his disciples to a mountain to pray, a place where he could get away from the crowds all around him, a place where he could experience something of the wonder and joy of his Father. And it was there on that mountain, on this occasion, that a special experience happened for his disciples. We don't know whether it's a special experience for Jesus or not, but it was the only one recorded. We know that he prayed a lot, but we don't know how often he prayed on his own and how often he prayed with the disciples. But on this occasion, there is this moment where he is somehow transfigured, and those who are with him are seen to be also something very, very different, and to be almost a crossover between heaven and earth. And of course, mountains were and are one of the closest places to the sky, and in ancient belief, heaven was just up in the sky. For us, understanding where heaven is one of those things that we may wonder about because we understand that the universe goes on and on and on. And my scientific mind makes me think that possibly the ability for there to be even the potential for parallel universes within our universe maybe explains how spirituality and physicality can be so closely interlinked, and that heaven may be just actually within the same space as we're in. But who knows? We wait to find out. But certainly mountains often give us that heavenly experience, that sense of something special. But most importantly, I think, in this story is the reality that Jesus chooses to go and find somewhere where he can meet with God. And that is something that we need to be good at. It's something that's not easy to do in our culture, in our world, where we have immense opportunities to do so much, and there is so many things clawing at our time all the time, that we are always needing to rush from this to the next to the other, and people expect so much of us. I remember well, and some of you too will be of an age to remember the questions that were put out as to what would happen when we had computers and they did everything for us. What would we do with all the time we gained? And the reality is that what we gained was the ability to do more. And because we could do more, we try to do more. And we try to do more and more and more. And we have great opportunity and great chances to do incredible things. And our work can be more dragged out of us and more achieved. And then people expect more of us. And time is one of those things that we seldom find much of. And one of my mantras is so often so much to do, so little time. But we need to find time for God, and we need to find time to go away to special places, to find places where we can be touched in ways that really make a difference, that really raise us up, that really help us to know something of what God thinks of us. And as Jesus goes to this mountain, what he is reminded is that he is special to God, God's Son, with whom God is well pleased. And for each of us, that is true. Each of us are God's children, and he is pleased with us. We may not yet be perfect. We may not yet have done great things. And at this point in Jesus' ministry, he is preparing to go to Jerusalem, to go to Jerusalem and there to face really hard times. And he needs the strength and encouragement to know that he is special. And all of us at various times, but particularly when we might be facing something difficult, need to know that we are special, that we are important, loved and valued, and we are loved and valued by the most important creature. Can we call God a creature? The most important being, I think, is probably the word we're looking for. The most important being in the whole universe, the one who can watch over us, who made us and thinks wonderful things of us, and wants us one day to pass between this earth and the heavenly places, but also in this earth to begin to taste of heaven. And the taste of heaven, we know, is love. Because God is love, and those who live in love live in God. And therefore we need to find time to know we are loved. We need to find space to know we are loved. And we need to find places that help us to do that and to reflect and to be near God. And whether that is by coming to church and finding a special place in the quiet and wonder of our wonderful buildings, or whether it is by going out into nature, finding a place at home, finding somewhere that really helps you, then you need to decide for yourself. But you need to find a way to make that regular, because without that, you will not be able to find the full strength that God has for you and the encouragement he wants to give you. Amen. We're going to have this old song done, as we know, in a more Celtic way, which enables us to reflect and allow God to speak to us and us to look to him who transforms our world as we see our world in his perspective and see him more fully. When the Lord comes, he'll bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us admit our failures and weaknesses. Father, we confess we often look only for mountaintop experiences. We want our faith to be lived at the heights alone. Father, we admit that our faith can falter when life is difficult or mundane. We want our faith to be lived at the heights alone. Father, forgive our desires, free us from our ways, open our minds. We want our faith to be lived at all levels, we pray. We recommit ourselves to walking with you every inch of the way, every moment of the day, whether it be fair or foul, knowing that you'll be faithful to us even when we lack faith in you. Amen. O God of healing and wholeness, we bring before you the leaders of our world in need and ask that they would have the discernment to listen to each other and to you, and that there may be justice and peace. A moment's silence to bring to God our own thoughts and prayers at this time. We bring to you the leaders of the church and other religious organisations and communities, and ask that they would have discernment to listen to each other and to you, that there may be vision and unity. We bring to you those with a responsibility for healthcare, doctors, nurses, administrators, ancillary workers and more, and pray that they may be strengthened and encouraged. We bring to you those with healing needs, especially any known to us. And pray that they will be met with physical and spiritual help. We pray for ourselves. Help us to set aside time for you, to listen for the unexpected and respond at your time and to your glory. Amen. We pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Dad in heaven above, let everyone look up to you and the area where you are in charge grow. May what you want happen on earth as perfectly as it does in heaven. Please give to us what we need for today. Forgive us when we think or do wrong things, just as we don't hold it against those who hurt us. Guide us away from whatever we might want, but is unhelpful to us. And protect us from all that is nasty and destructive. For you are in charge of everything. You have the power to do it, and you are awesome. You always were, you are now, and always will be. Amen. Our final song today is Christ Be In My Waking.
Christ be in my waking as the sun is rising. Christ be in my resting as the day is ending, coming and refreshing, watching through the night. Christ be in my thinking and my understanding, guarding me from evil, walking in the light. Christ be speaking every word a blessing, pure and not deceiving, grace to all who hear. Jesus, this is my devotion, all my life to know you, every day to walk with you. Savior, you're my deepest longing. Christ be in my gladness for the joy of living, thankful for the goodness of the Father's hand. mercy draw. Jesus, this is my devotion. Faded, nothing left to cling to, every pleasure jaded, every well is dry. Christ the loving shepherd draws me with his kindness, leads me from the desert to the streams of life.
So may your heart be at peace and your mind be at rest. May you be confident in who you are and share God's gifts of light, hope, and grace with those you meet and those you pray for. And may the blessing of God fill your hearts with hope this day and evermore. Amen. And we pray together. Go in peace to meet God in the extraordinary and in the ordinary. Go and listen, go and hear, go and respond, and know that God will give you peace.